May the continuity issue be resolved in everyone right now without any more delay as we prepare to run the gauntlet of 2014. And what a gauntlet that is. There is likely to be a scenario unfolding that is going to truly catch us unprepared. And this will jolt us, and we will lament, and we will say, why were we unprepared? Why did this catch us this way? How come we didn't see this coming? All right, but we did see it coming, didn't we? We did see it coming. We have known for a long time that there are extraterrestrials not only out in this galaxy, but here on Earth. And where are they, you say? I don't see any. They're under the ground. All right? They have installations within mountains, under the surface of the topography of this planet. And they have very luxurious digs there. And they have been living there for a while, waiting for the time when they will come pouring out of their dugouts onto the surface of this planet. They are waiting for the opportune time. The opportune time will soon be here. That opportune time includes the collapse of Wall Street and the stock market. So many, many people have now been suckered into this bull market, not realizing that it's all been set up to collapse the entire economic system of the planet. When this occurs in conjunction with the debris field of the four horsemen of the apocalypse, which is these four comets that have come in simultaneously and strewn a massive debris field in the inner solar system, we expect at least four stones, space rocks, to come in with significant impact on the planet. So you couple these events together of the confusion of incoming space rocks, fire from the sky, a lot of smaller rocks probably, with the collapse of the stock market, and people will be absolutely fit to be tied, unglued, shaking, trembling, self-medicating, desperately trying to pretend that they saw this coming and they knew exactly what was going on and they prepared for it, when in fact they haven't. And into this sort of vacuum steps the extraterrestrials who have been living underground here. And they will likely be very large, giant-like types of beings. And their strength and power and size and dominance will impress the people of this planet to such an extent that the people will bow down and worship them and say, ah, you've come here to save us. Is that right? And they will say, yes, of course. They will say, we are your gods. We are the ones that made you. We have come back for you to help you. And they will be worshipped, and people will do whatever they ask the people to do. We have been preparing. They have been orchestrating events on this planet. So society is tilting towards accepting the type of culture that these extraterrestrials will bring about upon this planet. The decadent culture, the immoral culture, the wicked culture, the culture of anything goes that they want to have go. The subservience of people, the willingness to surrender their freedoms. All of that has been cultivated ahead of time. So when these confluence of events take place, the space debris, the debris fields, and the incoming from the debris fields, the collapse of the stimulus plan QE3, as the bull market suddenly turns into an incredible bear market, and everybody finds out their investments are worthless. You have then utter chaos upon the surface of this planet. And into that chaos, of course, the ETs arrive from underground. They've been here preparing for this, actually, on this planet. And people will just worship them, give them a standing ovation. These are the events that lie in our future. And so you might ask, how do we possibly deal with these events? There is a way. There is a way. The way of tranquility is the way. The way of tranquility has been suggested to us throughout the ages, and yet we're intrigued by the potentiality. And we say, let's be stimulated into some sort of new situation. So instead of going into the true tranquility, which is our true identity, which is this fold of spacious freedom and a complete spacious support of what we are, we instead continuously try to stimulate ourselves into being more fearless, more aggressive, more death-defying, more confident in self-importance, and all the egoic strategies. And that has led us to a point where we are now ill-prepared to deal with what is going to take place in this world. Very ill-prepared indeed. And that's a sad thing. That's a very, 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 very sad thing. And yet, it doesn't have to be that way. Doesn't have to be that way. What the world needs is shock absorbers. The shock absorbers of the world are centers of tranquility, where the people of the world can feel this tranquility and calm down from their panic and decide, no, we don't need to fall for this ruse, this stratagem, this trick. We have our great teachers. We have our great direction. We have a goal. We do not need to throw away our freedom and our rights and our liberty and worship and bow down to these ETs, because I tell you, these ETs are very, very nasty, very decadent, very degenerate, very wicked. They treat people as their playthings. They feel they're utterly superior. They treat us like cattle. And worse, most certainly worse. And yet they come as our liberators, our saviors, those who know how to fix all the economic problems of the world. How to set everything so it all works. They come with new energy, new this, new gifts and trinkets and toys, etc. But they know not of tranquility. They know nothing of liberation from delusion. They demand worship. They demand idolatry. They demand everything that we should be getting out of. So it's a bum deal. A very bum deal for us. So these shock absorbers, those who are established in the tranquility of the true self, who are abiding in the vision of blessedness, These will act as shock absorbers, and people will go there and feel the smoothness, the absence of agitation, the absence of conflicting thoughts, the absence of dualistic relativism, the radiant, pure calm and clarity. And then we'll say, this is better. This is much better. We're going to go with that. And they will calm down. Whereas those who do not avail themselves of the help most certainly will throw their agitation, their inner agitation, into external adulation instead of tranquility. Tranquility is not adulation. Tranquility is dispassionate. It's smoothed out, beautiful, seamless sameness, zero dimensionality, vast, immeasurable calmness, without any need to think about it. It is not manic, it is not depressed, it seeks not adulation. But those who are agitated will throw this into adulation, worship of the ETs. And they will form a slave-master sort of relationship. Which is a very unstable thing, isn't it? And the ETs know it's unstable. And they say, we got to control everybody because we know how unstable it is. Does it ring any bells? How about the systems we've had throughout history here? The overlords, the aristocracy, needing to control the people who worship them and feel so inferior to them. Yeah. Because there have been alien bloodlines in this planet throughout history. And those bloodlines have instituted the forms of aristocracy and control in this planet. But we don't want to go back to that. We don't want to go back to that. We want to realize our true sovereign status as a thought in the mind of God. An eternal thought in the mind of God. For that is what we are. We are an eternal thought in the mind of God. And the thoughts of God never leave their source. And so we shall ever be eternal. Without any need to establish this through thought or any other means of establishing it. It is simply true, self-evidently true. We abide in the immeasurable smoothness of pure spaciousness at all times, at every moment, without any possibility of it being otherwise. We don't need to worship spaciousness in order to abide in it. It is impersonal. It is there for all. It is there for all. And it's this realization that it is there for all. All for one and one for all. It is there for all. That is what brings us peace. It is not simply the realization that I dwell. It is there for me. It is there for all simultaneously, effortlessly. This is the true liberation. Nothing needs to be saved. Everything is already saved. Nothing ever fell or separated. It was only a dream of separation. It all seems pretty clear until the chaos comes about. And therein lies the trouble. And this is something that is very concerning. We need to focus on tranquility. But more than that, we need to somehow step into tranquility. And potentially we need to somehow be distanced from the situation here on this earth that is to come. We need to be aware of the times that we live in, and be aware of what our options are, and make wise choices. And sometimes it seems as though it's impossible. We can't seem to figure it out. And other times we seem to get it. The trouble is right now that the future is so close. These events are so close to us right now that they tend to be causing a reverberation in us. The future is reverberating in us right now, is the trouble. And I say to you that you must not self-medicate at this time. You must not give in to agitation and stimulation at this time. You must continue your faith at this time. And have faith that you are going to have a breakthrough, that you will manage to shake off the reverberations of the future, that some insight will come to you, that you will hear it somewhere, perhaps here, and you'll say, ah, I get it. And the reverberations of the future will smooth out right now. How about that? Smooth out the reverberations of the future right now. Is that not possible? Is it not possible? As the reverberations of the future come at us in every way, can we not smooth them out? Like that, smooth them out. So they're not all coming after us like that. Smooth them out. I see we can. I say that insight will come, like a miracle, because it is our will to do so. It is our will to do so, and we will do so. It will be like a miracle for sure. And that's where the tranquility starts. That this little bit of advice is given to those who are ready for it. And they receive it. Like a communion. They receive it. And they say, yes, I am going to smooth out the reverberations of the future that are all agitating me like this. And I'm going to smooth them out. Very smooth. And I'm going to be tranquil. So we do not wait for the future to impact us. We've already smoothed it out. It's not reverberating in us. This is the key. This is the key. So, I am certainly willing to receive such information, such advice, such smoothing outness. It's necessary because the reverberation is so strong that it's causing agitation of the nervous system, which is leading to a sort of a dreadful fatigue and a dispiritedness, actually. A very severe dispiritedness is now being felt by many on this planet because the future is reverberating back into the past, and we're picking it up. And we say, uh-oh, this is not good. This is not good. And we cannot seem to shake it. Why? Because it's coming. It's coming. And we have not applied the crucial clarification. We have not applied it yet. But we will apply it. And that may be, needs to be very soon. Very soon. But the theme of 2014 is tranquility. Which is why you see this video the way that it is. The anxiety, the concern, is not going to go away just by enduring it. Okay, it's going to get worse. And if we do not get shock absorbers in this world, people are going to start self-medicating at some point. And that is when the wheels are really going to start coming off. And the pressure to self-medicate, I can feel it. It's very severe right now. I feel like it. I feel like I've gotta do something. I've gotta drink some coffee. I just have to, you know, I've got to pep myself up. I feel so dispirited. There's some kind of crushing force coming in the world, isn't there? There's something that seems that is going to just crush the very core of our civilization. Our way of life, what we're used to. And of course, when that happens, people will form a reaction formation and grab a hold of the ETs, who will form a one new world order, one world governance bureaucracy, and they will absolutely kowtow and worship them and feel that they're sacred, and that nobody dares say anything bad about them, or it's hate speech, punishable by perhaps death. There have been those systems in this world where the aristocracy, anything that was done that they didn't like, punishable by instant death, you see. This is the trouble we are getting into right now. This is what's been foretold. This is what we've been warned about. This is what we have been prepared for. And yet, we are short just one simple little insight right at this point. Just one simple little insight. Surely we can get that. And when we do, we'll probably laugh. You say, ah, it's so simple. That is great. So simple. Not a problem. We can do that. So, have faith that such an insight is available to us. Most certainly it must be. These times, these turnover times have been known about in advance. It's going to get going, I would say, in the first quarter of 2014. Perhaps as early as the second month of 2014, the wheels will start coming off and the turnover times will be here. But we need to get this insight of how to smooth it all out. We need to get it right now. Otherwise, we will already be in a bad state of mind when the turnover starts to happen. And each one of us needs to reach deep and become receptive to this bit of advice of how do we actually, pragmatically, banish these reverberations and become an ocean of tranquility. The answer is right beneath the surface, I know that. It's right there. And then these shock absorbers will be present in the world to help everybody out. This is how it works. And the destiny of those who are helped out is a very bright destiny. You will not have to be worshiping the beast. You will not have to be worshiping the beast at all. You will be freed of that for sure. So, when you hear that trumpet, you know the time is at hand where it's time to be insulated from the reverberations. It is time to be dwelling in an ocean of tranquility and drop the intrigue. It is absolutely essential to drop the intrigue. This will be done. This will be done. This will be done. And as you hear these trumpets, you know the time is getting very, very near. So just know that. Know that, okay, this is the time I came here for. This is the time. It is now here. This is the time now where I decide, yes, let me be immersed in an ocean of tranquility. Very simple. Very simple. All right. Just enjoy. Just enjoy the tranquility, the peace, the calmness. Is out.